The message is broken creation. Ever since man disobeyed and distorted God in the Garden of Eden, in Genesis chapter 3, almost every sinner will get caught in sin lie. No, that was not me. I was just holding it for a friend. I accidentally ended up on that website. I was afraid of you, God, because I was naked. No, Adam, you are avoiding God because you have sinned. Another one is this. When we are God caught sinning, we blame others. God, it's not my fault. It is the fault of the woman you gave to me, and she gave me some fruit from the tree and I ate. Almost there was no real thought about it. Adam failed to mention that he was there. The entire encounter with the serpent, and he does nothing as a leader to protect his wife or to stop it. But he blames her. And she in turn blames the serpent. And God asked Eve, "What have you done?" And she said, "The serpent that deceived me, it is his fault." So you see, sin entered into the creation just as the Bible says. In Romans chapter 5 verse 12, when Adam sinned, sin entered into the world. And Adam's sin brought death, so death spread to everyone, for everyone have sinned. God creation was God, hidden from God, lied about, and blamed someone else. It is still what we do today, almost every time. I know without a doubt, it was the lie that I lived for a long time ago. The same as many of you today. Only remedy for my sin is a Savior. The only remedy for yours is a Savior. And the only remedy for our sin is a Savior, Jesus Christ. And only hope for humanity, that broken creation, is for God to make us new. In 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17 to 18 says, "Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation have come, the old have gone, the new is here. All this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ and gave us the ministry of reconciliation." But the tough thing about sin is that it gives you a quick, immediate pleasure, but over time, it is like an acid to your soul. Sin is attached to your soul just as acid destroys the container, the same way sin will destroy you one day. And so the serpent always promises to do this or that, and that will make you feel better. At the first, it seems true. Excuse me. But what the serpent never shows us is this: the consequences that eventually come because of sin. Yes, it looks good. Yes, it tastes good. And yes, it opens eyes to knowledge. But it never shows you the separation from God and death. In Genesis chapter 5 verse 4 says, Adam lived a total of 930 years and then he died. That's what sin brings. Adam died, Eve died, they all died, and one day we are going to die. So that's why the Bible says in Adam we all die. And that was not God wanted. God had made a provision for them to live forever. The tree of life was there, and that's the source of life. But then again, what did Adam and Eve do? They end up eating from the tree of knowledge and good and evil. The banishment from that garden meant separation from the source of life and God's presence, and Satan did not show them that, the consequences of sin. He never does. In all creation was under the curse of sin. All creation became subject to the consequences of Adam and Eve's fall. This world we live is a sinful one. And we should not be surprised at the consequences we are to live with and living by. But God has a plan. Like Apostle Paul said in Romans chapter 8, verse 18 to 23, we need to understand that this world is under the rule of the evil one. That is the Satan. The philosophy is to make you feel happy. If your eyes see it, you can have it. If your eyes see it, you can want it. If your friends desire it, you can get it. If you boast about your ego, you can capture it. And so that's why John tells us in 1 John chapter 2, verse 15 to 17. Do not love the world or anything that's in the world. If anyone loves the world, the Lord the Father is not in him. For everything in the world, the lust of the flesh, The lust of eyes and the pride of life comes not from the Father, but from the world. And the Bible says, the want and desire passes away, but everyone who does the will of God will live forever. Amen. Now listen to Brother Kingsley. I live under the influence of evil one for many years with a heart of selfishness and self-gratification and rebellion against God's holiness. I lost after the things of this world. I live not for myself only, but for the sins that capture my life. That's what sin does. When sin captures you, you are a slave to unrighteousness of the devil. And we see, and we ought to know, when I live this life, only thought about myself, not about other people. What sin consequences cost me? Me, I know that when I was in sin, when I lived in sin for many years, 17 years in club, I never thought about God's righteousness. Because sin blinds you, my dear friend. Like many of you today, I was lost, worn out, dying, almost dead. And spiritually dead, yes. And then God stepped in. He showed me the consequences of being lost. And he pointed to me a Savior, Jesus Christ, who died on the cross to pay for my sins. Even the sins that I thought was unforgivable. So friend, when I surrender and I gave up fighting with God, I was buried with Christ in baptism. I received the God of the Holy Spirit. On that day, he made me a new creature. He changed my life and my heart. The old have gone and the new have come. Now I know without a doubt, he can do the same for you today. If you are willing to believe in him, if you are willing to give your life to him, if you are willing to give your heart to him, for the Bible teaches and the Bible tells us in Colossians chapter 5 verse 17, in Christ we become something that never existed before. We become a new creation in Christ Jesus. The old and the broken creation is gone. You see, only God can do that. Only God have what it takes. Because when God speaks things, he's coming to creation. And there's nothing God cannot do. And God does this only through Christ Jesus, our Lord. The Bible tells us in John chapter 1, verse 1, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. So the Word of God is Jesus Christ. When God said there had been light, there was light because Jesus Christ put it in motion. When you give your life to Jesus today, he will give you and remove you from the old self to the new self. The Bible says all things came to be through him. And without him, nothing came to be existed. The creation was made by God through Christ Jesus, and creation being made anew through Christ Jesus. And those who are in Christ Jesus, they are those who have been born again, including me. I have a new life, a new creation living in me, and that is the Holy Spirit. Never before existing creation that await a new heaven and a new earth. All creation grown for this day. And I know I do. For the Bible says in Romans chapter 8, verse 22, for we know that the whole creation has been growing together in the pains of a childbirth until now. In verse 26, for the creation was subjected to futility, not willingly, but because of him who subjected in hope that the creation itself will be set free from the bondage to corruption and obtain freedom of glory of the children of God. So when we come to Christ Jesus, we are a new creation, we are children of God. Then we can cry out, Abba Father. That it means Daddy Father. That means you are a child of God. The old have passed and the new have come. So please invite Jesus Christ into your life in order for you to move from the broken creation to the new creation, which is a life filled with the Holy Spirit. Let me bless in the mighty name of Jesus. Jesus is Lord.